Okay, this is a fun section. This is video number 2 in chapter 3, and we're going to be adding and subtracting algebraic expressions. So this goes with 3.2. There's the pages, write them down, and fill in this target. So in this section, we're going to be using different properties and what we learned in section 3.1 to add and subtract linear expressions. And this is a vocab word that we'll fill in next. Another word or term for this is to combine like terms. So we'll go over that in the examples and see what that means. Okay, so linear expressions. So linear expressions are algebraic expressions, which we said before are just numbers, variables, and symbols, so your operations and things. But now to make it a linear expression, it can only have an exponent of 1 on the variable. And we don't even bother to usually write an exponent of 1. So in linear expressions, you won't see anything like x squared or y to the third power or z to the fourth power. No exponents at all. So some examples of linear expressions would be 2x plus 4 and negative 7y minus 6. As long as the exponent right here, what would go right here, an exponent on the variable is only 1 to the first power. And we don't even write that. We don't write an exponent of 1. So those are examples of linear expressions. Okay, next I want to make sure we just review how to use the distributive property. We looked at it a lot more in the first unit, but it comes up in this chapter a lot. So the distributive property is when you have a number outside of parentheses, and it gets multiplied by everything inside the parentheses. So if I was going to actually do out the distributive property on this first one, I'd be doing negative 4 times x, which gives me negative 4x, and negative 4 times negative 2, which gives me positive 8. And then I just bring everything else down. This takes a little getting used to, especially when you see negatives in there. Like this negative, we're just going to think of as negative 2. So I had negative 4 times negative 2, which gave me positive 8. Let's try the next one. Here I have to distribute the 3. So I'm going to be doing 3 times 2z, which is 6z, and 3 times negative 4, which is negative 12 or minus 12. Remember now in 7th grade, minus signs and negative signs are really actually all the same thing. Then I just have to bring everything else down. I want to make sure I don't lose anything, copy it all down, and that's what I would get for that one. And then, next one. Here I have a negative 5 that's getting distributed to the things inside the parentheses. So negative 5 times y is negative 5y. And then negative 5 times negative 2y actually makes positive 10y. Okay? So that's a quick review of how we're going to be using the distributive property. Now here's some steps. Write these steps down, and we're going to be following these steps every time we want to simplify linear expressions. So when we say simplify, in this case, we're actually going to be adding and subtracting all the like terms together. So you can see the directions either way. It might say add and subtract linear expressions, or it might just say simplify them. But these are the steps. Step number 1. Do out any of the distribution, kind of like we just looked at. Distribute anything that's outside of the parentheses to everything inside of it, and then write it out. So for this one, I would say, okay, the 4 times 2x is 8x. 4 times negative 7 is negative 28. And I rewrite it so I get rid of the parentheses. So step 1 is to actually distribute and get rid of the parentheses. Step 2. Distribute any subtraction or negative signs. It might not look like there's really anything to do here, but whenever you see this negative out in front, remember we talked about how that's kind of like an invisible negative 1. So I actually have to distribute that times everything in the parentheses and get rid of the parentheses again before I can keep going. So I would be doing negative 1 times 3x, and then negative 1 times 5. And that's how I distribute a negative. It doesn't matter if it looks like it's a subtraction sign or a negative sign. If it's right out front of the parentheses, you got to distribute it to everything inside the parentheses. Okay, the next step is going to be to group any like terms together. So in this next example, 3x plus 7 plus y minus 5x, you can see that I have some like terms. I have some x's here and some x's here. The key is to kind of get them together so that you can start combining them. It's really important that you keep the sign of whatever is in front of that term. So this, even though we don't write it, this is a positive 3x. Then a positive 7, a positive y, and a negative 5x at the end. So my like terms that I'd put together are 3x and negative 5x. And then I can just copy along the y and the 7. But here, my next step was to group those like terms together so they're next to each other. And then the final step is just to combine them. And when we say combine, that means to actually add or subtract them. Okay, so we're looking at positives and negatives, putting them together. What do you end up with? So in this example, 3x's and negative 5x's, I'd end up with a total of negative 2x's. And then to finish simplifying it, I just bring everything else down. So I'm going to talk through these examples together, and then you'll have a set that you can do on your own. All right, for these, let me get a better pen. The first one, I don't have a ton of room here. I know you don't have a ton of room either to rewrite them, so we're kind of going to have to move across the paper. So 3n plus 5 minus 2n, I don't have any distribution. I don't have any negatives that need to be distributed, so I'm ready to just group the like terms together. It's important that I notice that that's a negative 2n. I got to keep that negative glued to that term. So I have 3n, negative 2n, I'm grouping those together, and then the 5. And then I would just work and combine the n's together. 3 minus 2 would leave me with 1n, which I don't even have to write. Really, I would probably just say n plus 5. Okay, the next one, I do have distribution to do. So my first step is to actually distribute and rewrite that. 3 times x is 3x. 3 times 2 is positive 6. Nothing, no like terms there, so I'm actually done. This one, I do have a negative to distribute, so I need to rewrite it before I start combining any like terms, distribute that negative. So I'll just copy the 2 down, that stays in front. A negative invisible 1 times x is negative x. A negative invisible 1 times 1 is minus 1 or negative 1. And I do have like terms. The constants here are like terms, so I should group them together. 2 minus 1. And then minus x. We usually write the variables in front when I give my final answer. So what I have left here is a negative x. And then when I put my 2 minus 1, I get positive 1. That would be my final answer. Okay, on the next one, again, I have a negative that I need to distribute before I do anything else. So copy down the 5, but then a negative 1 times 1. Is minus 1. A negative 1 times negative n turns into positive n. So a negative times a negative gave me positive n. My constants are already together. I'm ready to just combine those like terms and write a final answer. Again, the variable is going to go in front. And then 5 minus 1, positive 4. Okay, this one I have to check for distribution first. I do have to distribute this 3. So I'm going to rewrite it first. This whole term would be 3 times x, and then 3 times 1. So now I'm looking at 4x minus 2 plus 3x plus 3. I don't really need the parentheses around the first one anymore. So I'm just going to rewrite it. Actually, let's erase that and rewrite the like terms together. I have 4x and 3x. Minus 2 and then plus 3. That'll save me some room. So 4x plus 3x put together makes 7x's, and a negative 2 right here, negative 2 plus 3 is just 1. Okay, last one that I'm going to do together. Looks like I do have lots of things to distribute before I can start. So I need to distribute the 5 on that first one. That would be 5 times x. And 5 times 2 Now I'm ready to look at my second set of parentheses. This right here can get a little confusing. We need to think of this as negative 2. I'm distributing a negative 2 times the x and a negative 2 times 2. So negative 2 times x is negative 2x. And then negative 2 times 2 is a negative 4. So now I'm going to rewrite it with my like terms put together. Remember that that negative sticks with that 2x, and this negative sticks with the 4. So when I rewrite it, I've got 5x and negative 2x, or you could say 5x minus 2x. And I also have 10 and negative 4, or 10 minus 4. Now put your like terms together. So right here, my x is 5x minus 2x would leave me with 3x. And then 10 minus 4 would leave me with 6. That's my simplified answer. Okay, so here's the problems that you're going to do as practice. Remember your steps. Look for any distribution. Look for any negatives that you have to distribute. Put your like terms together. And then just combine them and simplify it. So try these. Pause the video. Try them. And then we'll come back and check. Okay, take a minute to check them. Let's go through them together. In the first one, I just had two like terms, add them up. This one, I had two sets of like terms. I rewrote them together and then simplified it. Here, they all just got combined. In this one, I again just rewrote it with the x's next to each other and then combined them. This one, I had to distribute that negative. So I showed the work, the negative times the x, negative times the 6, then simplified it. Turns out all the x's drop out, the 6's drop out, and I get nothing left, 0. And then this one, again, I had to distribute that negative 2. Careful here that you're actually distributing a negative 2, and it would give you this when you rewrite it. Then I just put my x's together, put my constants together, and got a final answer. So that is the video on adding and subtracting linear expressions.